Hey guys, welcome back to Coin Knowledge. So today I just want to kind of go over two altcoins in the gaming sector that we've covered a few times, you know, quite often on this channel, you know, over the last, you know, year or so, a couple of years actually. So if we take a look at the gaming sector, obviously we can take a look here and see that gaming over the last 30 days has really been rallying upwards, you know, in price action across really all of gaming, as we've seen Bitcoin go up in price. And this obviously, this does not pertain only to gaming. We've seen a huge shift to the upside across, you know, the general crypto markets. But if you take a look at gaming, I mean, the overall market cap of the gaming sector has gone from under $15 billion to well over $20 billion, which isn't, you know, a small feat. That's a big chunk of capital to actually get injected into the gaming sector. So that's why we're seeing so much green across, you know, the 7-day, the monthly, across all of gaming altcoins. And as always, before we get into the two specific projects we're going to be covering in today's video, if you guys get value out of content like this, or if this channel has helped you in any way, if you could consider subscribing to the channel and liking the video, your support means literally everything. Now, with that said, let's get into the two projects. So first of all, the first project is going to be Myria Games. Now, Myria has been one that we've covered really, I mean, for over 2 years now, you know, since before the token even got released. We've been on Myria for quite a long time. It was one that we were buying during the bear. And then obviously, if we look at the 1 year, Myria did quite well, you know, from bear market price to when we saw gaming run at the last quarter of 2023. And then, like most gaming projects, it has kind of just had a rough summer, but we've seen that across the board. But if we look here again, over the 1 month, it is up 67%, and at still a relatively low market cap, you know, especially if you're looking for like that mid to lower cap altcoin, and you have a risk tolerance. So if you want something a little bit lower, as far as, you know, not in the billions of market cap, but you want some kind of lower cap project in the gaming sector, I still think Myria is a great option. Now, we're going to be talking about a couple pros and cons of Myria, but first of all, if you're not familiar with what Myria does, I've said it multiple times and I stand by it. I do see Myria really as, you know, kind of this cycle's Gala Games competitor. They do a lot of things similar. You know, they had a revamped website over the last year here. So they have well over, I believe, 150 games, well over of, you know, 150 games building on their platform here. It's obviously a place for games to get built on. They also have their layer 2, Ethereum layer 2 blockchain, which will have like no transactions. So the Myria L2. They have some, you know, key games that are coming to their platform. Again, on both these projects, we've made so many individual videos covering them in further depth. If you are interested in learning more about either project, you can find those videos on this channel. You just have to search them on the video tab. But if you take a look at it, again, so Myria is a great place for if developers want to come and build their Web3 game, they can come here. You know, they have transactions, they have, again, users using it as far as like developers and games coming to Myria, a docs team, and so onward. Now, Myria has, they've put out some, you know, a couple updates over the summer that we've covered here, but one thing that I think a lot of people wish, you know, was not the case. You know, Myria, they do have games from other developers coming to their, you know, their ecosystem, but they also have games that they build in-house too. So they have Meta Rush, I believe, Block Royale, and then they have Meta Cart, I want to say. So yeah, Meta Rush is just, the website's kind of not loading in completely right now. So they have Block Royale and Meta Rush as well. And then I think they have the Meta Cart game, I want to say. So a couple games here, but Block Royale and Meta Rush that it being built from Myria in-house. Now, those games are not out. They've said that they're going to be coming out throughout the bull cycle, later on in the cycle. But, you know, that's something that a lot of people are kind of getting tired of waiting on, it feels like. Now, you can wishlist their Meta Rush game, which I'll admit, you know, it looks okay. I don't think it looks anything like, you know, redesigning the wheel or anything like that, but it does look like a fun game. I have yet to play it myself personally, but so that's one con of Myria is that, you know, still to this day, you know, we don't have the in-house made Myria games out and fully released yet. So I'd like to see that, but you could always look at that as a potential catalyst for the future of in a gaming run. If they release those games, that could be a catalyst that really sends it flying. Now, I do kind of strongly believe that I feel for Myria, one, the sheer amount of games coming to the platform, but I think one of the biggest things that they have going for them is that gasless Myria L2 made strictly for gaming. Now there's other projects in the space that are doing that as well, but I do think it's going to be one thing that does separate Myria from other kind of studio hub plays in the gaming sector that, again, we'll cover another one here as a second project, but either way, if, when I look at Myria, I still do see Myria as, you know, a potential Gala Games run like a contender for the cycle. And at this market cap, even though it has ran significantly, so I wouldn't go aping into anything right now that has been on this much of a run, I do still think long term, I do expect Myria to still perform quite well. And a pro for Myria is that a lot of the vesting and the token unlocks really has occurred over its first initial year throughout the bear cycle. It was pretty aggressive. So right now, you know, we're looking at, it's less than like a 2x dilution between now and the end of 2025 for Myria. So as far as gaming tokens go, Myria definitely has one of the better, you know, dilution, because a lot of that dilution has already occurred. It's been out for a while. And in my opinion, obviously nothing I see is financial advice, or I always say I don't have a crystal ball, but I might have a magic, you know, or I might have a rusty like 8-ball I can shake. I don't think Myria is going to rug or anything like that. Obviously their team has been around. They are building their games. They have, you know, products to show. And again, it's just more of a project that has been proven for being out for so long. If we go to the all-time chart here, you know, it did release April of 23. So it's been out for quite a while, and I don't think they're going anywhere. But I always say I wouldn't be holding anything past the peak of the cycle anyways. So that is worth noting. But Myria is the first project that I think is still undervalued, and if you're looking for a Gala Games kind of competitor to have a Gala Games like run this cycle, Myria is probably still one of my number one choices. Now the second altcoin is Games for a Living. Now Games for a Living is a controversy one. You know, for the longest time it felt like Games for a Living everyone kind of just gave up on. I've always given you guys my honest opinion, my thoughts here, and I've always let you guys know that I still like Games for a Living. I still hold a position in Games for a Living, full disclosure. I've made that known multiple times over different videos. So I still hold my Games for a Living. I still think that Games for a Living is still going to have a pretty good run. If we see here over the 1 year, if we go to the alt chart, you know, when gaming was last running earlier this year, at the end of 2023, Games for a Living had one of the best looking charts, because they seem to only really keep going up, you know, forming new highs, higher lows. That's what Games for a Living was doing. Now, obviously, everyone likes to piggyback on the fact that they have an incredible team. You know, they have Trip Hawkins, which was the founder of EA and Digital Chocolate. So, obviously, titans in the Web2 traditional gaming ecosystem and the space and, you know, Web2 gaming. And Manuel Sort as well, you know, from experience from Activision Blizzard and Digital Chocolate as well. But when we look at Games for a Living, they've also done a website change. They have a few games. Now, one thing they have over Myria is that they actually have their games that are live. They have a few of them here, but that's just one of their games. But they have a Docs team. They don't have a blockchain or like a layer 2 like Myria, which is why I put Myria kind of on that Gala Games-like platform, because Gala Games has their Gala chain, which that's a whole other conversation. But Games for a Living, it is more of like a studio play, because that's what they're doing. They're building games, and all their games are being built in-house. So they have their Elementor Raiders game, which is actually kind of a fun game. That's been out for, you know, over a year, I think, something like that. They have their Diamond Dreams, which is almost like a Candy Crush mobile game. Jump Pump, which you saw towards the top of the screen. And then their newest game, Dead Zombie, which is like an RPG survival game. So they're focusing on different aspects of the gaming sector. Again, mobile, they have some mobile games in there. I'm very bullish on mobile gaming. Then they have their Elementor Raiders game, which is their flagship game. It's gotten a few awards actually over time. You can see they're on season 8. You can get in this game, you can play it today. And again, I think it's a pretty fun game for what it is. You're either going to like this kind of style game or not, but it's kind of a fun game. And then they also have their, I think their Dead Zombie is live on mobile devices. So you can actually download it on Android or Apple. So that is a working, again, product there. So they have that over Myria as well. Now they did actually recently start their marketing you know, campaigns. They said they're gonna start their marketing efforts, which has been one of the biggest hindrances for GFAL for the longest time, that they didn't really market the best in Web3, because when you look at their team, it is a very Web2, you know, history background like team, which sometimes can be an issue. You know, not just because they had a good, you know, track record in Web2 doesn't mean they're going to do well in Web3 necessarily all the time, but they do say they're going to start their marketing for their games, for their ecosystem, which we've been waiting for that for the longest time, for GFAL to start marketing. So it's good to see that they're finally doing it. And as I have said in the past, is that I don't mind them waiting, because if they had started marketing back in May when we had a terrible summer as far as all of our markets go, then all that marketing would have kind of been for nothing, would have been mute. Gaming was not in the spotlight. So I think it was actually a good move on GFAL personally. I support that move. And if we see here over the 1 month, they're up over a 2x, you know, 108% over the 1 month. They're still well over $100 million market cap. This thing, it might come down a little bit. So it is hovering around that $50 million market cap also. So a little bit lower than Myria. But I think when you look at a gaming ecosystem, a studio play like GFAL that has working products, a great team, I mean, that can't really be argued. More projects in the space as they come out are starting to have good teams too, but I do think GFAL's team is still pretty stacked for who they are. Now, they do have some dilution. For the longest time, I think they still do have like 1.5% or something like that comes out monthly, I believe on the 13th. It's been a while since I've looked at GFAL's vesting schedule, but you can find that on different platforms like Chain Broker, Crypto Rank, or reach out to the team. But they do have a little bit more dilution than Myria, but a lot of the dilution for GFAL has already taken place too. So I think the harshest parts of the dilution are behind us personally. And they do have, I believe, a 10-year vesting schedule for their team, if I remember right. But still, at a smaller market cap, I do think GFAL still has potential to be a runner, because they do have plans to put their Elemental Raiders game onto console, I believe by the end of this year. That was in their roadmap. So if they can do that, then I think that's going to be a huge catalyst to bring GFAL back into the scope of a lot of gamer, you know, gaming sector investors in crypto, because I think that games that get on console is going to be the next iteration of, like, whoa, they're doing that as far as like gaming projects go, if that makes sense, because we're seeing stuff like Off the Grid coming to console. And then I really do think that Games for a Living with their Elemental Raiders game is going to be the only other one probably. And that's really about it. And if you've been watching, you know, the videos or Games for a Living on this channel, they had that plan before, I believe, Off the Grid really got announced that they were coming to consoles. So they've been ahead of it, but just like their marketing, they understand that if they're going to do that, they should release it at the right time. So I do think those are bullish aspects for Games for a Living too. Now, if we take a look at, usually I don't do this, but I just want to give you guys an idea of where these things kind of stand as far as being undervalued, where they could go. Now, obviously, this is not financial advice. This could easily not happen for either one of these projects, and I'm not saying that it's going to happen at all. I'm just giving you guys some kind of comparison to let you know what happened last cycle, what could potentially happen this cycle if we get a crazy altcoin season, if gaming is a hot narrative, both of which I feel strongly will happen. But this, if we compare Myria where it stands today versus where Gala Games compares today, because Gala Games is the best comparison that we can make between projects now that are doing similar stuff versus projects we had last cycle. Gala Games does still stand at like $1 billion in market cap, and they're not really involved with Web3 gaming. They've made a couple errors as far as like mistakes go, but if you know, you know. If not, this isn't the video for that. But looking at Gala Games, still, Myria is still like a 10x underneath, you know, undervalued from Gala Games. If we look at where Gala Games got last cycle, it was over a $5 billion market cap, and they didn't really have that much of an ecosystem. If you were around, they had like Townstar, I think Spider Tanks after really the blow off top, and then that was it for the most part, if I remember correctly. So again, I think both these projects have a little bit more going on than what Gala Games did at that time when it reached that $5 billion market cap. But again, just making the comparison to what we had then versus what we have today. So if Myria were to potentially get to the market cap of Gala Games at the peak this cycle, that is still around 60x undervalued from where Gala Games got to at the peak of last cycle. Again, I stress, I'm not saying this is going to happen at all, but even if it did, a quarter of that, even half of that, especially with the dilution being again, less than a 2x. If Myria got pumped by, let's say, big influencers in the space, let's say they have their games released, they get on more exchange listings, it could easily become a top performer in the gaming sector, I believe. But they really got to get their games out, and they have to get, you know, brought up by big influencers. That's just part of the game. That it is what it is. And obviously, we have to have an insane altcoin season. Gaming has to be one of the hottest narratives of this cycle. So there is a lot of catalyst that has to happen in order for something like this to even come close to happening. But again, this is just showing that Myria is undervalued from Gala Games currently, and Gala Games really shouldn't be at the evaluation that they're at today. That's just my opinion. Now, if we go to the same thing with GFAL, now on here it is showing that GFAL is at a $34 million market cap, but again, I just say it's around that $50 million. So this is just obviously not exact numbers anyways, just showing you guys it's still undervalued even more so than Myria. So it's still undervalued than Gala Games today. And if it got to where Gala Games got last cycle, you're still looking at, you know, about 100x around there. So again, I think both these projects are still undervalued today. And please don't take any of those comparisons as gospel. Don't focus so much on the X factor, just the fact of the principle that I think both these projects are undervalued compared to where we had Gala Games last cycle. I do think they're undervalued still. And we look at Games for a Living, where do I see it going? Well, if you look at the market cap, this little blip here was inaccurate. We actually had a video on it at that time, but it's pretty close to where its, you know, previous all-time high market cap was, you know, not even that long ago in the grand scheme of things. But now where it had gotten to, it was getting, again, around that $25 million market cap. And, you know, Games for a Living, if you were watching it, that was a great time to accumulate. Now, it might get back to those levels. I don't know. It really depends on what happens in the next 30 to 60 days and across overall markets. As we move into October, it's traditionally more of a bullish month for crypto, but we'll see where gaming stands there. And if they do their release of Elemental Raiders on console or any other game releases, then again, there's going to be more catalyst events for that. If you look at Myria, where Myria had gotten to as far as market cap goes, you know, Myria, you know, it got up to about a $225 million market cap, and recently it came from a sub $50 million, so nothing crazy, not quite a 2x, but closing in on it. It did at the recent peak of this last 30-day, 7-month, or 7-day run, but again, same with Myria. It needs those catalysts to happen. You know, Games for a Living, their biggest thing, I think, holding them back is marketing. Myria, I think the biggest thing holding them back is they just need more in-house games released. It's been a long time. One thing to know is that Myria does have nodes in their ecosystem, which, again, there's a lot of node operators, so they get their tokens every day, whereas Games for a Living does not. That is something worth mentioning, but either way, guys, these are two projects that I've always talked about them side by side because they do similar things, you know, as far as being like a gaming hub, gaming studio, gaming infrastructure. You know, they're in that space together, so, but I do still think that if you're looking for a project like that, at that $50 to $100 million market cap, I do think these are two great contenders still. Now, if I had to pick one over the other, I do personally like the fundamentals of GFAL a lot more just because the team, they actually have games that are live, but I do think Myria could potentially get talked about more from bigger influencers like Alex Becker, just as an example, and they do maybe potentially have more catalysts that could still happen in the future, but either way, that's my opinion on these two. Let me know in the comments below, what do you guys think of Games for a Living? What do you think of Myria? If you had to choose one, which would you choose? I know there's obviously plenty of other gaming altcoins that could be, you know, could have an argument to be made that they should have been on this list instead of one or the other that are accomplishing similar things. But I just wanted to talk about Myria and Games for a Living because it's been a while. Give you guys my opinions on them and kind of keep you up to date on what they're doing and where they could potentially go, since they have reacted pretty well to the markets and the pumps that we've seen over the last 7 days, that last, you know, 30 days. That's what you want to see. You want to see if these things are dead or if they still react to the overall market and when gaming does pump. And these two are obviously still pumping and they're still reacting quite well. So it shows sign of life and support. So that's my opinions. Take them or leave them. And as always, guys, if you got value out of today's video, consider liking the videos. And if you want, there is an optional way of supporting the channel, which means a lot. There's a Patreon linked below, or you can get into the Discord. It's free to get in there. And As always, if you guys can like the video, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share the video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. All right, see you guys.